Before we begin today's video, me and my team have curated 10 best SOPs for your university applications to UK and Ireland, and the best part is they are completely free. All you have to do is go to the description box or the pinned comments to download them. So go check it out right now.
Hi folks, I'm Anushka Maheshwari and we are at the University of Edinburgh. I'm pursuing my Master's in Psychology of Mental Health here, one of the most popular courses among study abroad aspirants. And today, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about pursuing this course in the UK. Okay, so a little bit of background first. I did my undergrad in mass media at St. Xavier's College in Mumbai, after which I worked for 3 years in the fashion tech industry. During the pandemic, I experienced burnout. This led me to realize how inaccessible mental health services were and the sheer scope of innovation in this space. This motivated me to finally pursue my long-standing passion for psychology and mental health. Coming from a background of marketing and communications, I did not have an academic degree in psychology, which meant that I had to find a course that catered to individuals from other professions. Psychology conversion courses are meant for individuals from other backgrounds who want an internationally recognized degree in psychology. UK is one of the few countries that offers this program. Not just that, there's an area of mental health that's evolving in the UK that I was really passionate to learn more about. So, I began this intensive master's program in 2021 and I'm set to finish it this year in 2022. I chose the University of Edinburgh for the program's specific focus on mental health because of the academic excellence in terms of faculty as well as research, and because the degree is accredited by the British Psychological Society. My personal experience has been great so far. I've had a chance to immerse myself in a subject that I really love. From learning about psychological concepts and theories to applying every lesson to the context of mental health. I really also enjoy the diversity in the classroom. This program hosts students from various backgrounds in terms of ages, professions, and these are students who might have been finance experts or even artists. At this point, I should mention that this program is quite intensive, especially if you're new to research and methods of scientific inquiry. You're not just going to be learning about theories of psychological therapies, but you're also going to be practicing statistics and critical thinking. This can get quite daunting, but the program is designed in a way that will ease you into the subject. The content is very rich and extremely helpful for anyone looking to get a kickstart in this field. My advice would be that you brush through basic psychological concepts so that you're not caught off guard by the pace of the program at the beginning. When choosing the program and the university that's right for you, I'd recommend that you consider 3 aspects. Number 1, choosing the right course. This information is readily available on the university website and gives you an overview of what you're going to learn. Choose the course that suits you best. Number 2, delivery of the course. Attend virtual open days to find out more about the course as well as the university. What is the cohort size going to be like? How is this program going to be delivered? What sets this university apart from all the other ones? This will help you make a well-informed decision. And number 3, choosing the right city. Choose the city that suits you best in terms of your budget as well as your priorities. The budget should suit you in terms of the cost of living, and the city should have good connectivity so that you have ample opportunities as a student. So, the next major point of concern is what you can do after the program. The answer to this depends on your personal goals and aspirations. So while this program opens a range of possibilities, but there are broadly 2 directions that you can take. Number 1 is that you could be studying ahead. You could be pursuing a PhD, a clinical doctorate in psychology, or any other related field. Number 2 is that you could be working in the field. So you could be working as a mental health support worker or a psychological well-being practitioner with the NHS. But it's important to keep in mind that this program does not give you the clinical qualification to work as a mental health counselor in the UK. It does give you the necessary prerequisites though for further education and training. Alternatively, you could also work in human resource management or transfer your skills to other areas of business and innovation. After all, psychology is everywhere. This course gives you the eligibility to apply for a graduate work visa, which allows you to work for 2 years after the completion of the course. You could also go the skilled workers visa route or the startup visa route based on your career experiences and your aspirations. So lastly and most importantly, how do you fund your education? The fee for international students for this particular program is £24,000. You could pay this upfront or in installments. You could fund this personally through sponsorship or by taking a student loan. I personally took a student loan. There are also scholarship options that are available to students from India. But bear in mind, scholarship application deadlines are quite early. So I'd advise that you start as early as possible on your applications. While you're here, you could also take up part-time jobs which are readily available to students. The Tier 4 visa permits you to work for 20 hours every week during term time. During the program, I worked remotely as a strategy and operations consultant for a mental health startup based in Asia. I worked there for 3 months and usually for 15 hours a week. I found this opportunity through my network on LinkedIn. I'd recommend that you use this time at the program to connect with industry leaders and get as many learning opportunities as you can. So guys, that was it on my end. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please like it and share it. Subscribe to Elite Scholars YouTube channel for more videos like this. If you have any questions, please put them in the comment box below and I'll answer as many as I can. Thanks for watching. Bye.